The woman who broke news of the 9/11 attacks to Australia joins me now. Sandra Sully, welcome.
Hey, Chris.
Now, you've got a unique place in all of this. I remember watching you, like so many people, live on air breaking the news of this to all of us.
Yeah, look, it was some evening, and frankly, it's pretty hard to believe that it's, you know, been 20 years. The world and America was paralysed at the time. We all were. The raw and unfolding footage, you know, the horror that gripped us in a way we'd never really experienced before. I mean, we had all witnessed an attack on our way of life for the first time, firsthand. And we all remember watching on in horror and the tremor, the trauma and the terror for hours on end, and not knowing, you know, where it was actually going to end. And of course, knowing how horrendous it was for all of those stuck in the towers before they came down. Just awful.
And you're processing all of this live on air while you're working. I can imagine how difficult that was. We've got a clip of you on the late news. Let's have a look.
Now to some breaking news just through, and CNN is reporting tonight that a plane has crashed into the World Trade Center. The latest piece of information that has just come to hand is that now a second plane has crashed into the second tower of the World Trade Center.
I've never seen anything like this in my life. I never thought I would. This is terrible.
Quite unbelievable reports tonight. Unconfirmed reports. A third attack has just taken place on the Pentagon.
What goes through your mind now watching that?
I'm actually sweating, and it does take you back to a really horrendous night for everybody. I think I was just so struck by how audacious it was. You know, 19 hijackers, four planes striking at the very heart of Western democracy, the world the way we knew it. And of course, our very own Prime Minister was there at the time. And America was under attack on home soil. And it was just so surreal, to be honest. Our hearts broke for all our allies. We were frozen in fear, and I think we knew the fallout was seismic. I mean, we live with the reverberations of that day to this day. It was a defining moment for everyone, for the world. It's always a day of immense sadness for me and for everyone involved, and my heart's always with those who lost loved ones. And to be honest, Chris, it's why I chose this weekend to get married 10 years ago on this day, to give me better memories of this time of year.
Yeah.
So thank you for having me on.
Well, happy wedding anniversary for yesterday.
Yes, and my gorgeous husband's son.
I know it was a tough day for the world and a tough day for everybody, but you were outstanding that night. You did an incredible job. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Chris.